The World Holocaust Forum happens every 5 years, but what was so remarkable about this session was the gathering of 40 world leaders from across Europe who came together here in Israel at Yad Vashem to commemorate this very somber anniversary. It was deeply moving.
What's the next stage? You know, after all these leaders met, what do you expect? What do you hope? And what do you even demand?
So we want to see the leaders learning the lessons of the Shoah to apply it to the fight against anti-Semitism today. That means, number one, having clarity about what's anti-Semitism, which is why the IHRA definition is so important in all of its examples. Number two, being honest about the willingness to call it out whenever it happens, whether it's on the left or the right or it's a religious fanaticism. We need leaders to lead and to stand up and speak out, particularly when it happens amongst our own ranks. Then number three, we need them to take action, whether it's anti-bias education in schools, whether it's training the law enforcement to deal with the victims of hate crimes. Ultimately, anti-Semitism isn't a Jewish problem. It's everyone's problem. It's a sign of the decay of a democracy, and it's a sign of a sick society. So we want to see leaders lead and take action to stop this from happening again.
Regarding what we're seeing in America, the numbers are going up. What could and should be done in America?
We think it's long overdue for elected officials and public leaders in the United States to stop the surge of anti-Semitic incidents. Whether it's in Pittsburgh or Poway or Jersey City or Muncie, it comes from all sides, and we need to do something about it. For us at ADL, that means, number one, getting the government to engage. We want to see a domestic terrorism law because we think that's important to call these acts what they are. They're acts of terror. And number two, we need a long-term approach for us. That means mandating Holocaust education, because education ultimately is the best antidote to ignorance. Then number three, we think it's time to get the companies involved. Silicon Valley is part of the problem. You know, the social media sites have become breeding grounds for bigotry. So we think it's incumbent for the companies to act, to take measures to ensure that hate speech has no place on their platform. Now, there are laws in the U.S. We have a First Amendment in the U.S. We have laws that are much more flexible on hate speech than what you have in Europe, where Holocaust denialism is illegal in many countries. But the fact of the matter is, whether there's a legal responsibility, there is a moral accountability, and we want the companies to live up to that.
And now that's not happening enough?
We know that it's not happening enough. The companies, we think, have been far too lackadaisical about hate speech, about Holocaust denialism, and they've allowed the toxin of anti-Semitism to spread, but they can take action to stop it, and that needs to happen.